Hey guys, and welcome back. Now, first of all, a big thanks to all of you that came up with some suggestions concerning the prophecy. Basically, what I've done is I've added all of your ideas into a big list, and I've assigned certain traits to each of your ideas. So basically, there are some ideas to fulfill the prophecy that anyone could really do, but others are locked behind traits such as lunatic, cruel, possessed, zealous, lustful, any of these. So depending on what kind of character we play as, we might try to fulfill the prophecy in a different way. And I think that obviously ties in very nice into the whole role-playing aspect of CK2. And also, obviously, we will have characters that might not care about the prophecy at all, but the only trait that would really make sense would be the cynical trait. So this is actually kind of interesting because Aegon the Conqueror is a cynical character, and I think that's fine, because so far we haven't really, bothered about the prophecy too much. Obviously, a little bit here and there, but none of our major, decisions really have been solely reliant on the prophecy. So, basically what we're gonna do, we're not gonna have too much too deep of a look into the prophecy as long as we're playing a cynical character. We're mostly going to base our, decisions on the traits that we have. But once we have a character that maybe is mystic or that is maybe zealous, that could be one. These characters will look more into the prophecy, and that's going to be playing a more major role later on. That's just for now. Also, I wanted to obviously quickly mention that I have appointed some of the characters that you guys have suggested. We'll talk about them in a second, but first I want to talk about one of our Kingsguards, Sir Walder the White One, also known as Walder White. Now this guy actually is a scholar. He's a very unique Kingsguard, because he's not only a good fighter, but also obviously a rather smart man. And he actually came up with the idea to start the White Book, right? We have a book where we write all of the stories of our former Kingsguard, or of our current Kingsguard, obviously, all of their tales. And so this is a really nice background story someone in the comments actually came up with concerning the founding of the White Book. So I thought that would be really cool. So he now has a unique nickname. Now actually, it was supposed to be just Walder the White or Walder White, but that was not possible, so we have Walder the White One. And somehow I get the feeling that this guy is an alchemist. I don't know why, but somehow I have that feeling. Anyways, so that's about our Kingsguard here, but also I want to obviously talk about the characters that I have now appointed. Now I actually initially just wanted to have two characters, but I ended up adding four characters, but only obviously two of them I assigned to a Baron. And the first off, we have our Lord Commander of the Kingsguard, Arion Kingswood. I actually renamed him to Arion Drake, and he is now of House Drake, obviously, and this is his sigil, a white sword on a blue background. He's already married, of course. Then we also have Gaemon Whitehaven. Now he has a white tower on a black background, and he is currently our King's Justice, if you remember. So basically, I've used these characters, but I just simply renamed their house. Now, as for the two characters that I have landed, there we have they have two Rhaegars. We have Rhaegar Artaeus, who has a red bird on a black background, and he's married, of course, and he's the ruler of the Dragon Gate. And then, last but not least, we have Rhaegar Quill, who is the ruler of the King's Gate. And, well, I wasn't actually able to fully modify the sigil as requested, so if you want this to be changed, then please let me know. Otherwise, this is the closest I could get to what you wanted. Those are the people that I have added into the series so far. Actually, let's have a quick look at our council. We now also have these two Rhaegars as our advisors, which I think is interesting. Now, obviously, as I said, since we are cynical, they will not play a huge role just yet, but maybe as soon as we die, our son will be more interested in the prophecy. We shall see. That was that. Then a lot of you people told me I should ask Rhaenys to become my vassal, but yeah, it's not possible. Look at it. She is a king. I told that, or said that to a lot of people, this is not possible. Kings never accept vassalization. Unless, obviously, you fight, you press a claim for them, and you're an empire to your title yourself, but that's not the case here. So, if we have, basically, in order to, you know, incorporate this into our own realm, Rhaenys would have to die without producing a child, because then we would actually it says we're the heir. Oh, it says we're the heir, not our son. That's interesting, because I remember Aena was the heir before. In any case, so basically, if Rhaenys dies without an heir, then we inherit, otherwise our lines will be split. But that shouldn't, you know, really bother us too much. Other than that, right. Now, obviously, there was the huge issue concerning Aerys and his wife. Now, I probably should have made a straw poll just to make things a little bit more clear as to whether or not you guys want me to marry Aerys to that whore girl? Whore? That's supposedly how it's pronounced. Whore? Anyway, you know who I'm talking about. And, well, a lot of people, I guess the majority of people actually supported this. But a lot of people have raised some concerns, first of all because of her age, second because I would have to use console commands, yes, but we'll talk about that later, and thirdly people said that, well, the line must be kept pure. Well, first thing, well, this is actually the only, I guess, argument that I'm not going to accept, because Aerys' line, for all we know, is already tainted. He's just a legitimized bastard. We don't know who his mother was. We don't know. So for all we know, this line is already not pure. So I'm not really too concerned about this. However, the age problem is indeed a problem. And obviously, using console commands is kind of problematic because basically what I had to do, because Valyrian Faith is not eligible to marry Faith of the Seveners or Ironborn rulers, basically I have to use console commands for the betrothal, and then I would have to use that again, probably for the marriage. And that seems a little bit strange, so I think I'm going to hold off marrying off Aerys for now. But I have some more candidates. So basically we have this Ironborn lady. She's attractive and she has that bloodline, which I just think is a really great idea. But we have a second option, and that would be Armory Tully. And this girl actually makes a little bit more sense from a roleplay point of view, because basically House Tully is the strongest bannerman to Aerys Baratheon at the moment. This guy is ambitious, so he probably would want his daughter to be married to the new Lord Paramount, and he's not zealous. So even though they would not accept the marriage, maybe because of religious differences, I don't think that Edmund would really care that much. So I think that his daughter could potentially marry Aerys. She's also not as young as the whore girl, so that would also be a little bit better. And she does have a bloodline as well, so we would have basically the same advantages from marrying that other girl, but not the same disadvantages. So I think maybe this would be a better pick. But I've also had a look around. We have some more options. We have Hera Seltiga, she's only 4 years old, and then we have Rhaes Sunglass, who's also 4 years old, but she's attractive. Now, these last two options are obviously High Valyrian, that would keep the bloodline pure, technically. The other two would not, but the other two options would obviously create a new bloodline, which is also cool. So basically, long story short, I'm going to leave a straw poll in the description of this video, where you guys can pick who of these four girls Aerys should marry. We have Armory Tully, Fernie Horror, Harry Saltiga, and Rhaes Sunglass. Now, he might actually take a wife himself in this episode. If so, then I don't know. But anyways, I'm gonna have that link in the description. Alright, after this 9-minute intro, without doing anything, I know this is terrible, but guys, you know, this is... I want to take it slow, because I think this is a great series and I don't want to rush things, and especially right now, while Beleriand is still wounded, we can't really conquer anything anyways. So I want to make sure that we set up our realm properly before we move on. But yeah, I think I have finally mentioned everything that I wanted to mention, so I think we can just go ahead. Okay, I'm pause and go ahead. See what things are happening. So as I said, we are now going to wait until Beleriand actually comes, heals up, until his wound is healed, and then we're gonna go ahead and conquer. And I'm pretty sure that I want to conquer Pentas first. I don't really know why, but I just feel like this would fit. And then we're probably gonna go after Tyrosh or Omir, Tyrosh, Lace, and then maybe Bravas. But yeah, we'll have to see. What's this? Yeah, you all just try and keep... Why do you... Yeah, god damn it. Yes, yes, yes. You all want to try and kill someone. This is very annoying. Now, because I have this on auto-stopping plots, I'm just constantly being bothered about this. But, you know, there's not much I can do about it. What's this? Ooh, the crowning of the king. Oh, we didn't have that before. In the name of the gods, I, King Aegon of House Targaryen, promise, pledge, and guarantee in the sight of the gods that I will be the protector and defender of the realm in all ways useful to it. However many, in so far as I am supported by divine assistance according to my knowledge and ability. Alright, I thought we were crowned before, but apparently that was not the case. Well, there we go. So today I was crowned by Stormsinger Jothis and formally received the title of King of the Andals, the Rhoynar and the First Men, Lord of the Seven Kingdoms, and Protector of the realm. There we go. So we get some extra prestige, but that is not really necessary. We already have 4,000. What we do need is actually some money. We need some more money because obviously we need to improve our fleet as well as the Red Keep. Now we do have a flagship, if I'm not mistaken, right? We do have... No. Where does it say Student of Strategy? It doesn't actually show that we have a flagship. But I'm pretty sure that we constructed one. Don't know where that modifier went, but maybe it's here? No, that's a household god. Yeah, I don't know. Anyways. Ooh, what's this? The Conclave of the Sith has elected the Grand Maester. Ooh, okay, so you are now the Grand Maester. Very good for you. Alright. Wait, who was the Maester before? This was my Maester, Maester Lucan. Okay, so I don't need him anymore, technically. Does that mean... Okay, yeah, so you are now the Grand Maester. Alright, that's fine. We've just basically switched out our Maester. Yes, thank you, Mom, for all of these notifications. I don't really need them, though. Yes, everyone's killing everyone. Holy shit. I might have to turn this off, because this is getting very frustrating. Yeah, so obviously we could still convert to the Faith of the Seven. I might do that at some point, depending on what the prophecy says. But obviously we're a cynical person, so I don't think we necessarily care about this too much. Other than that, I could imprison. It says I could imprison someone, but I don't think that's actually true. Lord Godry of Dire Den, you want to become the master of... Replace Lord Reylu Abaram and his Master of Laws. Couldn't you end your plot? He does not want to end his plot. You know what? I don't really care. I mean, I don't want you to be plotting, but I don't really care. I don't think it's worth imprisoning you for. That wouldn't really make much sense. Okay, how is Valyrian doing? Oh, Lord Commander Robin Darkland becomes Valyrian. Oh, that's very nice. Awesome. Now look at that. Look at that. Our Lord Commander of the King's Guard became... Valyrian Faith. Awesome. More people joining would be amazing. We shall see. And we are now slowly becoming a master of strategy. Okay, so we are a student before, now we are adept of strategy. That's fine. We're basically waiting. We're planning our invasion of the Free Cities so that we can reclaim old Valyria. Now, obviously, as I said, this is technically part of the prophecy, but still, it's the overarching goal of this campaign, so we will strike out and try and take over the Free Cities, as well as Old Valyria, as soon as we can. And, oh, look at that! Edmund wants to fabricate a claim on the King of the Riverlands. I think it would definitely serve Ori's very well, marrying that Tully girl, because then he could form an alliance with his strongest bannerman, because I think, yeah, look at this, House Tully is the strongest bannerman in the Riverlands, so having an alliance between these two would definitely serve them very well. By the way, we actually have an alliance with Queen Rhaenys of the Stepstones, and I also have a non-aggression pact with Ori's. So that was, I was just going forward off camera actually, and you know, to get all of the marriages in, and that was what popped up in between. But anyways, Arkhan Ori's Targaryen has informed you that the new flagship for the Westerosi fleet is complete. The Dromont has Over 700 oars and a huge sail is blazoned with the arms of House Targaryen. Many hundreds of people gather to watch it launch into the sea, and all say it is the one largest ship they have ever seen. Awesome. So we gain some prestige. Actually, Ori's gained some prestige for that as well. And some Marshall. Very nice. So we have an enormous flagship. Now it has been launched and blessed. You must now select a name for your flagship. Name it King Aegon in honor of myself, Lord Arion, Queen Visenya. Ooh, if I click more, do they go away or can I come back to these? I don't know. But no, I think we can click on more and we'll be able to come back to this. Name it King's Landing. Oh, damn it. Ah, shit. Oh, no, it did work. Dragon. Dragon? I don't know how often I have to click this. Intent. Oh, formidable. Okay, I don't know how often this... That's kind of strange. You know what? I hope we come back. Victory. Duty. Warbringer. Bloodless. Warbringer. Warbringer is actually kind of cool, but now I think we're going to continue. Imperious. No, let's just... I'm just going to keep clicking on this. Okay, so we can come back. Alright, yeah, that was kind of strange. So I'm going to have to think of a name. I think we're going to go with one of these. Queen Visenya, because of my beloved wife. King Aegon in honor of ourselves. Or Lord Arion after our father. Well, we are very proud. King Aegon. Name the flagship King Aegon. Well, I don't know. This is difficult. What are we going to name our flagship? No, I think Lord Arion. After my father, although... Name it King's Landing. No, that's stupid. Yeah, okay, I'm going to have to click through this again. Because maybe one of these options... Name it Dragon? No, that's stupid. What else was there? That was something like Intent? No. Formidable? Ardacious? No. Glory. Name it Glory. Our flagship Glory. Seems stupid as well. Victory. We could call it Victory. Duty? Nah. Warbringer. I kind of like Warbringer. Bloodless. But we're not bloodless. We have fire and blood. Imperious. Man, I know this is not too important necessarily, but I don't know what to go for here. You know what? Queen Visenya. Queen Visenya. Do I want this? Well, she has given us... No, I'm gonna name after my father. Because, here's the thing. If I name it Queen Visenya, then Rhaenys might be mad. And I don't want that, necessarily. Naming it after myself would be a good idea. But no, we're just gonna go with my father. I need to end this here. Yes, there we go. I need to stop. I can't be bothered with this for too long. Alright, so Lord Arion is the flagship of House Targaryen, and now we're gonna have to start and expand the royal fleet. As soon as we have 200 gold, we're gonna have to do this, because we now have a flagship, but one ship is not enough to invade the free cities. We obviously have our dragons that we can fly on, but I think it's also important that we have a bigger fleet, so that we can actually transport our troops over to the free cities. So I think actually, even though Beleriand might heal, I think we're gonna have to wait with the invasion until our fleet has been built. I think that's what we need to do. So whatever takes longer, the healing of Beleriand or the construction of our fleet, we're gonna have to wait for both of these things to finish before we can start an invasion. But yeah, so we're gonna go running, simply because we think that's a good idea. So yeah, you shall do that. And what's going on here? Your ability to take down any men in a brawl. Okay, so we gain some more prestige, which is one of the few things we do not need more of, actually. Yes, all kinds of people are doing all kinds of stuff, but I'm not really too concerned. And look at this, there's still some of Rhaenys' troops. I like that. Luma Parmat Lo. Okay, whatever. You want the Lord of the Fingers. Is that you? Yeah. I think there's a plot against Ronald Aaron, but I don't know. Let's see if Orys has picked Wyfit. He has not. There's actually people in his court. But yeah, he's probably not gonna pick one himself. We shall see. Rhaenys, are you continuing your conquest? No, she basically seems to be content with just staying in the Skulls. Okay. Well, as long as we have our lines, I don't really, care that much. We're gonna actually wait one more, one more month or something like that until I can actually click that ambition to expand the fleet. And oh, what's this? Lauren. I could imprison you. And your plot. You do not want to. You know what? This is something I don't really care. If you want to fight the Vale, that's... I guess that doesn't... Well, it kind of does matter because the Aerons, they bent the knee peacefully, whereas the Lannisters fought me. So I think I'm rather going to side... In a conflict, I'm going to side with House Aaron here, I think. But yeah, let's actually go ahead and... expand the royal fleet, and once that is done, as I said, we're just gonna have to wait for Beleriand to heal his wounds, and then we can strike at the Free Cities. But anyways, guys, that will be the end of this episode. I know we had a very long intro, but still, we have been able to finish our flagship, and now the invasion can start. Maybe the next episode. But anyways, make sure to check out the the straw poll in the description of this video concerning the wife of Orys, and I'll see you guys next time.